Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another What I Eat in a Day on WW. I'm gonna be sharing with you my entire day of eating, my breakfast, lunch, dinner, snacks, dessert, and you are going to see an absolutely phenomenal dinner recipe. So if you're looking for some great WW friendly food ideas, some of my most favorite things, then all you have to do is stay tuned. So here's my breakfast for this morning. It's about 7:30. I'm gonna get this nice and cooked up. So I'm gonna do two over easy of my very favorite happy eggs. I'm going to do one serving of Orida shredded hash browns. I'm gonna have a couple of cuties, and then I'm gonna do two slices of the Sam's Choice uncured turkey bacon. So I'm gonna get my breakfast put together, and then I will show you my completed breakfast and then give you the points. So here is my breakfast for this morning. Super easy. It's meal prep day, so I'm super busy with that. So I wanted to make it nutritious, filling, and easy. So what I have here is underneath my eggs, I have one serving of Orida shredded hash browns. That's basically 1.5 cups frozen. I do measure my hash browns frozen. A lot of you have asked me about that. So that is 2 smart points. I have 2 over easy. I like them on the runny side so I can mix them in with my hash browns. Eggs, which is 0 smart points. I have 2 slices of Sam's Choice turkey bacon for 2 smart points. So my entire breakfast is a total of 4 smart points. I may have a fruit, but I think I'm gonna save it for my morning snack. And then of course I'm having some water. So this, my friends, is my 4 smart point breakfast. My baby girl is right here. This is right next to my chair while I'm eating my breakfast. She's patiently waiting. Are you waiting, Lola? Yeah, you are. You're waiting, huh, honey? And over here is Diesel. Again, on the other side of my chair, patiently waiting for his portion of my breakfast, which is always canned green beans. So here is my morning snack. It is about 9:45. I ate breakfast this morning. You saw it about 7:30. So I'm gonna be having my tried and true Built Bar. This keeps me full between now and when I can eat some lunch. I love these Built Bars. These are so good. 3 smart points. It tastes like a candy bar. Mine just came out of the freezer, which is my very, very favorite way to eat my Built Bars. Second to that would be pulling them directly out of the refrigerator. So this is only 3 smart points. My code has changed for the better from Built Bar. I will put that here on the screen, and it is down in the description box below. But you guys, this code lasts forever. You can use it as many times as you want. You can save 10% on either the sample box or the full box, and you always, always receive free shipping. So instead of being able to use the code one time, now you can use it as much as your little heart desires. So make sure that you take advantage of it. Order your Built Bars, stock up. I always have 2 to 3 cases on hand. I'm also going to be having 2 of my Halo oranges since I did not have a fruit with breakfast. And I'm still working on some water. So this, my friends, is going to be my 3 smart point snack. So excited. I don't know how that's comfortable. I don't know, buddy. He's still got his leg wrapped. We still have some time for healing. I'm gonna pull the wrap off here pretty soon when I can lay with him to make sure he doesn't lick it. But somebody's made themselves nice and cozy. It is 12:30 and it is lunchtime. So here is what I'm having for lunch today. So of course I have some grapes for my second fruit of the day. And then here on one of these Western bagel, these are the perfect 10 plus healthy grain. These actually are my favorite bagels, not only because they taste really good, but because they are only 2 smart points, you guys, 2. And this is a full size bagel, for 2 smart points. So I do keep mine in the freezer. That is the suggested way to store them. So I went ahead and popped out one of these bagels and toasted it up. You can buy these bagels on westernbagel.com. Use the discount code here on the screen to save yourself 10%. And right now they have a phenomenal deal where you can select 6 bags of whatever bagels your little heart desires for free shipping and only $37. And then if you use my discount code, you'll save an extra $3. So that makes all of your bagels less than $34 for 6 different bags. I love these Perfect 10 Healthy Grain again because they are only 2 smart points. So check out Western Bagel down in the description box below. So I toasted up one of my Western bagels. Here I have 2 slices or half of a serving of the frozen avocados. Let me show you those actually. These are the frozen avocados. So these are the Nature's Touch avocado chunks. I actually bought these at Costco and they are frozen, they're peeled, they're ready to go. 1 serving is 1/4 cup for 2 smart points. So I did half of a serving or 15 grams for 1 smart point. I love these avocados. It makes avocado life so easy. They don't go bad. You defrost them, you spread them, you are good to go. So that is my 15 grams of avocado. I also added just a little bit of this Organic Girl Protein Green Spring Mix, some tomatoes. Down here, I have 2 slices of the Sam's Choice Turkey Bacon, the same turkey bacon that I had on my breakfast sandwich for 2 points. I also added just a splash of Skinny Kitchen Ranch for 0. So that is going to be my bagel BLTA sandwich. And then over here, my friends, I have found a new delicious sweet treat. Thanks to Barrett Pastor over at Living on Track, I found these Crunchmaster Protein Brownie Thins. Yes, you guys, these are amazing. These are the salted caramel. They are so good. Let me flip these around here. You can have 32 thins for only 3 smart points. 3 smart points for brownie thins. Now I went ahead and cut mine down to 23 so that it ended up only being 2 smart points, but these are so good. They taste exactly like the crispy edge on a brownie pan. So yum, yum. I do have these linked down in my Amazon store below. They are a little bit on the pricey side, but this is a huge bag of these brownie thins. It's this almost 17-ounce bag, so there is quite a bit in here. It looks like there is about 15 servings. So a little on the pricey side, but they are really, really delicious. And again, they are in my Amazon store. So this is 23 of those brownie thins, and this is only 2 smart points. So my entire lunch, oh, I forgot. My Coke Zero orange vanilla, which I absolutely love. So my sandwich here is 2 for the bagel, 1 for the avocado, and 2 for the turkey bacon. That is 5 points. And then I have 2 points worth of the brownie thins. So my lunch here is a total of 7 smart points. Look what I picked up today. Happy mail. This is from my subscriber, Rennie Davis. So let me show you what she sent me. I'm so excited. So she sent me this adorable plush bunny dog toy for Diesel and Lola. They're going to love it. I can't guarantee how long these legs and limbs will stay attached, but they are going to love it. She also sent me this cute tube toy with a rope. They'll really like to play tug of war with that. She sent me these really cute matches. This is going to be perfect for our fire pit this summer. And it says gather, which is exactly what you do around a fire pit. So we have one out in our yard, so I'm excited to use those for that. She also sent me this super cute towel with all these cute little dogs on it. Absolutely love it. She sent a Starbucks gift card, which is so nice. She knows I've been really liking my passion tea, so she sent me this to use on my tea. She also sent me this Kinder's spice, so I'm excited to try this. We don't have this where I live. I've just actually never seen it. I don't know why my camera doesn't want to focus. But anyways, this is buttery steakhouse seasoning. She also sent me the Walden Farms caramel dip. And she sent me the Walden Farms chocolate dip. So super, super nice, way too generous. So thank you so much, Rennie, for the sweet note and for the happy mail. this is gonna be my afternoon snack. It's about 3 o'clock. I am a little bit hungry. So what I have here are 3 of my copycat Starbucks egg bites that I made in my meal prep. I'm gonna count 3 of these as 2 smart points. 2 of these is 1, so I'm just gonna add an additional smart point for the third one. And then over here, I have my amazing smart sweets. These are the fruity gummy bears. I love these so much, you guys, so much. And this is how many you get in a pack. A lot of you ask me the amount that you receive. I do have a discount code for smart sweets that will get you free shipping, which is amazing. It is here on the screen, and I will include it down in the description box, along with the link to directly get to Smart Sweet. So this is the number of gummy bears that you get in a pack, so quite a few, along with my 3 Starbucks egg bites. This is a total of a 5 Smart Point snack. I've got some sun going on today. Put me in the mood for some iced tea. So I'm gonna be using my Mr. Coffee Fresh Tea. I'll see if I can find this on Amazon. If so, I'll link it down for you guys. This thing is so old, but it is awesome. It makes the best iced tea. You put your tea bags in, some water. You can brew it strong or mild, and voila, out pops tea. Throw it in your fridge, and it's perfect. So this is the Trader Joe's peppermint green tea that I'm currently a-brewing. For dinner tonight, I am making crescent chicken. I am super excited about this. It is basically a rolled crescent roll dinner that is WW friendly, so cannot wait. Let me show you everything that is in tonight's dinner. So you're going to need some almond milk unsweetened, 2 cans of reduced fat crescent rolls, light butter of your choice, salt. I'm going to use Dax Original Red. These spices are amazing. They are salt-free, and they have, seriously, the best flavor. I do have a discount for Dax that will get you 10% off, as well as free shipping. They have so many spices, over 20, and they are all amazing. So I'll put that discount code here on the screen and down in the description box below. But today I'm going to use the Original Reds, which does have a little bit of a kick to it, but is going to be a nice complement for this dish because the recipe did call for Creole seasoning. You're also going to need some ground black pepper, some shredded chicken. I just boiled this on the stove. Diced pimentos, cream of chicken soup, fat-free or reduced fat cream cheese. And I'm gonna do a mix of the Trader Joe's light shredded mozzarella and of course fat-free shredded cheese. So let's get started on our dinner. So the first thing that we need to do is start creating the sauce for our dish. So here I have 1 cup of almond milk. We're gonna go ahead and add that. I also am going to add my 1 can of cream of chicken soup. And this is all on a saucepan over medium heat, or in a saucepan, not on a saucepan, over medium heat on our stove. So there's our can of cream of chicken soup. And then you can see here that I've measured out 2 cups of cheese, which is what the recipe calls for. It does want us to add about a third of a cup to this, or a third of the cheese to our sauce here. So there's the leftover cheese. I'm just gonna set that aside. And then we're gonna go ahead and add some ground black pepper. We're gonna go ahead and add our Dax Original Red. Remember, it's spicy, so I'm not putting a whole lot in there. And then we're gonna go ahead and add some pink Himalayan sea salt. And this is going to make our sauce. We're gonna allow this to cook down until everything is melted and nice and combined. Once your cheese has melted, see how that's nice and stringy cheese, you are good to go with your sauce here. We're just gonna go ahead and set this aside. This will get added to our dish at the very end before it goes into the oven. Once you've got your sauce made, we're gonna move on to our cream cheese mixture. So here I have 5 ounces of softened fat-free cream cheese. To that, I'm going to be adding 2 tablespoons of I Can't Believe It's Not Butter. And then we are going to mix that together with our handheld mixture until completely combined. I don't know why I can't speak today for some reason. It's been a long day. So we're gonna mix that cream cheese and that butter together. just until it is mixed. So you just want it nice and incorporated together. And then from there, we're gonna go ahead and add in our chicken breast. And we're also going to add in an additional 1/3 of our cheese. So I'm gonna do the same thing again. Add that into the mix, set the rest aside. And then again, we're just gonna give this a quick mix together. Watch your chicken, it does like to go flying around. So you're just gonna mix this together until fully combined. Once your chicken mixture is nice and mixed together, this looks amazing, you are gonna go ahead and add in 1 to 2 tablespoons of pimentos. So I'm just gonna go ahead and add this whole little jar. This jar is literally tiny. Look how small this jar is. So we're just gonna go ahead and add that. It looks like about 2 tablespoons of pimento. We're gonna get this a little bit more mixed together. And then we're ready to start assembling our crescent chicken. So this is looking delicious. So there's your mix once you've added in your pimentos. Next, you're gonna grab out your 9x13 pan and you're gonna grab your soup mixture off of the stove. We do wanna add about half of this soup mix to the bottom of our 9x13 pan. Go ahead and spread that out as even as you can. And this is what we're actually gonna be layering our crescents on. So we wanna make sure that the rolls themselves are not sticking to the bottom of our baking dish. And that's what adding a little bit of this soup mixture to the bottom does. You're just gonna set the rest of this aside to add to the top. Next, you're gonna go ahead and take out your crescent rolls. Go ahead and just set them aside. You wanna kinda keep them rolled up, and then you've got your chicken mixture here, and our plan is to add a heaping spoonful of the chicken mixture to the wide end of the crescent roll, so kind of like that, and then we are going to roll up the chicken mixture into the crescent roll, and basically we're creating a filled crescent roll, just like you would if you were making the crescent rolls without filling. You wanna go ahead and roll it up. Look at that, yum. All deliciousness in your crescent roll, and then you're going to set that into your pan. And then we're gonna take the next crescent roll and we're gonna repeat this process until we have filled and rolled all of the crescent rolls in both of our cans. So again, the wide end, you're gonna go ahead and put a heaping spoonful of the chicken mixture. I fold over that kind of loose end and then go ahead and roll it up just like you would if you were just making a crescent roll to eat. And I'm gonna go ahead and put these in the pan, get the rest of them rolled up, and we'll be ready to go. All right, once you've rolled up all of your delicious crescent rolls, we are going to take the other half of our soup mixture and we're just gonna go ahead and add it over the top of the crescent rolls. This is going to go into the oven at 350 for about 30 minutes or until the crescent rolls are mostly cooked through. Then we will pop it out. We will add the rest of our cheese to the top and toss it back into the oven for about another 3 minutes. But this looks absolutely delicious. So here's our crescent chicken out of the oven. Look at how delicious this looks. I'm gonna go ahead and add the last little bit of our shredded cheese here to the top of our casserole and then put it back in the oven for about 3 minutes. Just make sure that it gets the rest of the way cooked through and the cheese gets nice and melted, and then we will be ready to eat. I am also going to throw in the microwave some green beans so that we can have that as a vegetable. Here is the completed casserole. This looks amazing. This casserole, in my calculations, makes 8 servings. Essentially, you get 2 crescent rolls per serving. So I'm gonna go ahead and plate this up with my green beans. I will show you the completed dinner, but this looks so cheesy and so delicious. So here is tonight's dinner. This is so good. I am so excited. I tried a little taste and that crescent chicken is amazing. So what I have here is some of those Private Selection frozen green beans. I just simply added some spray butter, salt, and pepper for 0 points. And then I have 2 of the crescent rolls stuffed with the chicken, the cheese, and the sauce. So this is a total of 8 smart points. So this entire dinner is 8 smart points. Look at how cheesy and creamy and delicious these crescent chicken rolls are. Super excited for tonight's dinner. For dessert tonight, I am making a parfait. I'm gonna make it a little bit different than I have in the past. So here's what I'm gonna be using. So I have the raspberry smart cakes. This is what they look like. These, you guys, are amazing. They taste like a fresh, juicy raspberry. I'm not kidding you. With this delicious sugary crumb top, yum. 1 smart point for an entire smart cake. So you can eat both of these or this entire package for 2 smart points. I do have a discount code for smart cakes that will get you 10% off. A lot of times they have free shipping promos as well. So I'll put that here on the screen and I will link that down in the description box below. But the main component of my parfait is always, always a smart cake. They also are the same company that produces the 1 smart point smart bun. So make sure that you go check them out. I'm going to be having that with 1 of these berries and cream light and fit Greek yogurt. I'm gonna drizzle just a tiny bit of sugar-free chocolate sauce over the top, and then my layers will be mashed together with fat-free Ready Whip. So let me put my little guy together and I will show you my completed parfait. And here is my amazing dessert. So I have my yogurt layered with fat-free Ready Whip, layered with smart cakes, raspberry flavored, and then I topped it with literally like 1/2 a teaspoon of the Hershey's chocolate. So this entire parfait is 2 for the yogurt, 1 for the smart cake, a total of 3 smart points. Thank you for joining me on another What I Eat in a Day on WW. I hope that you enjoyed seeing all of the food that I ate throughout the day, as well as my delicious dinner recipe, little day in the life, little dogs, little happy mail. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you're new, make sure you subscribe. Hit the notification bell. That way you're notified each and every time I upload a new video. I'd love it if you'd give this one a thumbs up. Comment below. Let me know if I showed you some new WW food finds. And of course, I'll see you guys all in my next video. Bye.